Hey, hey, hey! Welcome back to Conversations with Carrie. Guess what time it is? What? It's book review time. Get it. Hands on the knees. Get it. Okay, sorry. Y'all know how I get about my book reviews. And it's been so long because one of them I'm going to go over took me forever to read. But how are y'all doing? What's been going on? Drop a comment below. And of course, don't forget to like and subscribe because y'all know I'm here. I'm giving y'all book reviews. Giving you some scripture and some encouragement too. You know, I got a little bit of everything for everybody. First, y'all already know, have you gone to carrielee.com? If you haven't, you slacking, go on and take a look. And don't forget to subscribe to carrielee.com as well, because if you're a reader and you love to read, or if you love to write, if you're a writer, let's help each other out. Let's talk to one another. But anyway, okay, we're going to dive right into these books. We're going to make this short and sweet. The City We Became. Listen, I read this for my book club, and I talked about it in my to-be-read list, and I had no expectations. All I heard is that, I've heard mixed reviews. I heard it was really good for some, and then I heard it was hard to follow for others. And this is my first time reading this author. So again, I was just like, okay, I think it's a great cover. You gotta see if the reflection, see this like little thing here, like you see the little light reflection. Everything about the cover made sense for the book. Like it's a thick read. And this definitely took me over a month to read. mainly because, y'all, in the beginning, I was like, what is happening in this book? What did I just pick up? Love action heroes, and I don't love reading sci-fi. I normally like to watch it, but like, you know, in a movie or something. But I was like, okay, this feels like, you know, also by a black author. I was like, I'm totally here for it. I'm gonna give it a chance. I'm just telling you, if you can make it past chapter two, you're good to go. Because even in the prologue, I was like, what is going on? Who, what? And they told me that the book was about the book is about basically the five boroughs of New York coming to life, and the each person embodies their borough. And so of course my favorite borough was Brooklyn. Like, where Brooklyn at? But that's because she was like this black woman who was like kind of prissy, but like, and like wealthy, but also like, you know, had a gritty past, and she was like rap for a living. So like all of that, like I was here for the characters. I just felt like some of it, I was like, what is going on? I was confused. And then when I felt like I was starting to get it, that's when it's starting to like go in a different direction. I don't know. I don't know if maybe me reading sci-fi is just the best thing. If sci-fi is your thing, I think you would love it. If you are a comic book lover, I think you would love it. I didn't love it, so I can't recommend it. Am I glad that I read something a little different from what I normally do? Yes. Would I do it again? Probably not. But yes, The City We Became, N.K. Jemisin. Proceed at your own will. Little Fires Everywhere. Y'all read this a while ago, and I'm so sorry I'm late on my book review. It's like, they should call it microaggressions everywhere. I actually think it's a great book considering what the country's going through. And let's not forget that black lives still matter, honey. Just because you ain't seeing that hashtag everywhere on your social media, let's not get it twisted. It's still a movement, okay? Not a moment. But anyway, this book is about a black woman and her daughter who, well, actually, you know what? In the book, they don't actually say she's a black woman. I'm thinking about, because I watched the series on Hulu, that it made me think that she's a black woman, because Kerry Washington did such a good job of, like, whoever directed and all of that did such a good job of bringing it to life. But actually, in the book, you don't know if Kerry Washington's character is a black woman. But basically, and you know what? That's why I should change that. I shouldn't say it's to call it microaggressions everywhere. I think the way they portrayed the book in the series made it like that. But the book itself is really a book about class as well. And I liked it, but I didn't love it. I actually liked the Hulu series better. And it's very rare that I like something that was taken from a book and I like the movie or the TV show better than the actual book itself. It took me a while to get through this one too, but also I think, I don't know about you, but sometimes I'm just now getting to the point where I feel like I can read consistently, and because I'm like, this is our new normal right now. I'm working from home. We making it work, and it's happening. But I didn't love it. but I've heard good things about this author, and I think I would read more of her books. I just didn't love this one necessarily, but I do think it's a good read considering the time. But you know, take that with what you will. And then A Woman Is No Man, and Etaf Rum. I actually looked her up on social media because I didn't know much about her. And the book was actually a really great representation about some Palestinian or Palestinian immigrants that moved to New York. It's very sad, though. I want y'all, like, it's about basically a mother who, a woman who becomes a mother. Like, she has an arranged marriage, and she gets married at a very young age. Which, side note, I don't know if y'all been watching the Indian Matchmaking on Netflix. I, like, totally binged on it last night. Okay, like, we might have to do a separate review for that. But anyway, so it talks about an arranged marriage, and it basically shows the cycle of arranged marriage. And I think it also deals with, like, generational curses almost. Like, if the mother and then her daughter, like, simultaneously, it kind of bounces back and forth. So it's about a 17-year, I think, in between the two. I might have got the year wrong. But the mother is, like, you know, an abusive relationship because ultimately, like, it's a hurt people type of thing. So the father is unhappy and ends up abusing the mother because he gets so much pressure from the mom and his father. And again, he saw his parents had an abusive relationship. And then she, her daughter is at the age where she can have an arranged marriage, but she finds out that she has other options, and she actually gets help from someone else, which I don't want to tell you who, because that would give away a big part of the book. But she gets help from someone else and how she can overcome this cycle. So I thought it was very interesting to read about a different culture, which is why I grabbed this book, but also to get her point of view, because I know from an author standpoint, she received a lot of backlash because she felt like she was painting a really negative picture of her culture. And I think we also have to read this and understand that not just because that's her story doesn't mean that's a story widespread. So I think it's really important right now that we're just reading books about other cultures and understanding what other families and people are going through. But I thought it was a good book. It was a little slow moving, and again, it was very sad. There's really no joy in the book, and I don't know, I was like, oh, that's a little heavy for me right now. So would I recommend it? Yes, because I feel like it teaches you, it especially if this is not your your culture, I feel like it will teach you something. And then also, it's important that we amplify voices outside of what people perceive as the majority. So as I think about writers of other nationalities, it's really important. So, you know, just like Celeste, like, she's an Asian woman, and Kay Jemisin, a Black woman, and, you know, for a Palestinian woman, I think it's very important that we're reading outside of what we've been always told to read, like, you know, about, like, white women and white men. You know, that those stories are great sometimes, don't get me wrong, because a good story is a good story, but also I feel like it's really important to embrace other cultures. So again, this book review, I can't say I'm like, oh yes, go read all of them. I probably would recommend reading this one first, and then Little Fires Everywhere. But I would say if you can watch the Hulu series, you'll be good to go on this one. And if you like comic books, you'll love it. If you don't, it's probably not going to be your thing. But you know what? Spread your wings. Expand your mind. Do a little something different. Okay, if you've read these, make sure you give me a comment below. And of course, please be sure to like and subscribe, because I am all still reading, and I'm about to start The Vanishing Half by Brent Bennett. So I had this on my quarantine to be read list. So this will be my next book review, and I'm really excited. This is my book club's reading this. I'm actually starting this today. So thank you for joining Conversations with Carrie. Until next time.